special edition of the Auto Car Show. We are coming to you from the world of motor shows, and this is the Mondial de l'Automobile, or much easier to say, the Paris Motor Show.
New launches, hot cars, and show cars. The Paris Motor Show was packed. In fact, the Volkswagen Group has showcased their star cars for the motor show the night before, and some of them definitely needed a closer look. Once at the expo, I jumped right in at the Volkswagen stall to check out a car that will be coming to India very soon.
Now this is the face of the new Volkswagen Passat. It has the typical Volkswagen Group styling, but along with that, it is a lot more aggressive, gives it a lot more presence, and it will be coming to India in the first half of 2011.
The Passat has a crisp new premium feel. Its face boasts of a wide prominent grille, like its elder brother, the Phaeton. Geometric headlamps replace the earlier rounded ones. These feature twin headlights with LED daytime running lights. The Passat also feels wider to look at. From the sides, you can see a more tense feel to the body. The sharp waistline flows back to the tightly packaged rear. New tail lights with LEDs help spruce up the rear. The Passat also comes with a nifty feature to open the boot. Just grave your foot under the bumper to pop the boot open. Perfect for when your hands are full with luggage, and the boot is quite spacious. But what is the Passat like on the inside? Volkswagen have been messed around with a successful formula. Changes to the interiors are select. The analog clock and a slight tweak to the dashboard design are the most striking changes. The seats feel brilliant, and I was busy testing the back seat.
Well, the Passat definitely has more presence now. What it could do with a bit more of is legroom. Even in the new version, it doesn't compare quite as well with the competitors in its class, most notably its own cousin, the Skoda Superb.
But Volkswagen doesn't feel that space is such a big issue.
But the Audi A6, Europe and India, has in, from the interior, has nearly the same size. So there's no difference between Passat and A6.
The Passat will come with a range of diesel motors, the familiar 2-liter CRDI being one of them. However, it can be either 138 bhp or 168 bhp guys. All petrol motors are PSI units, developing from 120 to 207 bhp. You'll need to wait until the first half of 2011 to find out which motors will be on offer in the new Passat in India. Another car on the Volkswagen stand that caught my attention was the Cross Polo. More ground clearance, tough plastic cladding, and a more aggressive sound just made it feel more rugged. Perfect for Indian roads, but this won't be coming to India. Will this car make it to India? The Honda Jazz Hybrid. It's a moot question. The Jazz has now been fitted with Honda's integrated motor assist along with a 1.3 petrol motor. It will take a lot from Honda to bring the Jazz down to India after the Civic Hybrid. But we know a car that's definitely coming to India, and pretty soon at that. The new Suzuki Swift. It is quite tough to think of this as the new Swift. It's an evolution of the first generation. It has the same swept-back headlamps, but they're much bigger now. Even the tail lamps are bigger. Actually, overall, the Swift has grown up. It is longer and even sports a longer wheelbase. But has that made a difference in the one area where the Swift lacked sorely?
In the back seat of the new Swift, you certainly get the feeling that the seat is set much higher, so you get more thigh support. You don't feel cooped in like before. Though it's overall grown up more, I really think that the growing up on the Swift has been done on the bonnet front, and inside, it's been shortchanged a little bit.
So while the back seat may not be much better than before, the driver is treated to a much better view. The preferred color is still a very somber black. New bits include a chunky hexagonal design for the steering and a dash that has a classy European flavor to it. Variable valve timing is also expected on the 1.2 petrol motor when the Swift comes to India.